Greetings. This is the third video in a series addressing the errors in Deedat's teaching that spirit means prophet. If you call yourself Muslim, you need to ask yourself, do you place any value on truth? So this is point number three. The error is that Deedat is not consistent with his claim Mohammed is the Holy Spirit. And inconsistent application of definitions is one sign that the definitions are either incomplete, inaccurate, or just plain wrong. In fact, one of the damning problems for Muhammad's religion and those who spread it and defend it is they are intellectually bankrupt when it comes to the inconsistencies of their claims. It is not the topic of this video, but I will mention but a few because they are so omnipresent. 1. Islam claims the Torah and Bible as credentials for Muhammad, but calls the Torah and Bible corrupted and untrustworthy. That is logically inconsistent. They claim Song of Solomon 5:16 names Muhammad, but insult the Song of Solomon, calling it a book of pornography. That is logically inconsistent. They claim that Allah is all-powerful, but believe he was impotent to preserve his message in the Torah and Bible. That is logically inconsistent. And the point of this video is another inconsistency. Deedat claims spirit and prophet mean the same thing, but he does not consistently apply this rule. Again, that is logically inconsistent. So to help demonstrate just how damaging and damning this inconsistency is, we're going to apply Deedat's twisted definition and make you see how badly it fails if it were to be consistently applied. But first, let's summarize the situation. Jesus promised the Comforter and named who the Comforter was, specifically the Holy Spirit. Since Muhammad claimed he was mentioned in the Injil, meaning the New Testament of the Bible, Islam is desperate to create such a reference. Mr. Deedat of Islam has contrived a teaching by which he attempts to claim that Muhammad is the Holy Spirit. And a foundational step of this tortured teaching is to claim that Holy Spirit really means Holy Prophet, and that Spirit and Prophet are interchangeable. But here is the problem. When you make a claim that Spirit and Prophet are the same, you must then be consistent in applying that rule in every situation. You must evaluate this new proposed rule by examining its uniform application. You may test this rule by seeing if it makes sense to substitute the word prophet wherever you find the word spirit. Now, a logically generous and forgiving position to adopt would be to limit this to considerations only of the usage of Holy Spirit and substituted with Holy Prophet. But as we have seen, Deedat himself is the one attempting to divorce his teaching from holiness or mention of God when referencing the Spirit of God or the Holy Spirit. In fact, Deedat drops the usage of the prefix word holy and seeks to only consider the word spirit. And whether we use the phrase Holy Spirit and substitute Holy Prophet in its place, or simply use the word Spirit and substitute the word Prophet in its place, Deedat's twisted and tortured changing of Spirit to Prophet proves to be an asinine divergence from logical truth. My point here is to demonstrate the foolishness of his error, number three. If Deedat is correct that Spirit means Prophet, then Spirit of God also means Prophet of God. So if Deedat is correct that Spirit and Prophet are interchangeable, You must live with the logical problems that teaching creates. Let's look at a few. Genesis 1:1. In the beginning God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And if Deedat is correct, Genesis 1:2 means, the prophet of God moved upon the face of the waters. Which prophet do you think that means, O Mohammedans? Which prophet do you think was with Allah during the creation? Which prophet do you think was Allah's partner during the creation? You know, the prophet always means Muhammad. O Mohammedan, do you really think that Muhammad was present with Allah on the day of creation? O Mohammedan, do you really think that Muhammad hovered above the waters before the day of creation? O Mohammedan, do you really ascribe to Muhammad an eternal position and a partnership of that magnitude? Can you see how Deedat's claim that spirit means prophet establishes Muhammad as Allah's partner at creation? Do you really elevate Muhammad to the position of partner with Allah, creating the worlds? O Mohammedan, that is only the first of hundreds of examples of the problems that Deedat's error causes. Exodus 31:3, and I have filled him with the Spirit of God in wisdom and in understanding and in knowledge and in all manner of workmanship. Applying Deedat's error corrupts the word of God to say, and I have filled him with the prophet of God, Muhammad, in wisdom and in understanding and in knowledge and in all manner of workmanship. What does that even mean, O Mohammedan? God has filled him with the prophet of God. God has filled him with Muhammad? Numbers 24:2. And Balaam lifted up his eyes, and he saw Israel abiding in their tents according to their tribes. And the Spirit of God came upon him. That verse becomes, and Balaam lifted up his eyes, and he saw Israel abiding in his tents according to their tribes. And the prophet of God, Muhammad, came upon him. 1 Samuel 10:10. And when they came thither to the hill, behold, a company of prophets met him, and the Spirit of God came upon him, and he prophesied among them. Applying Deedat's error corrupts the word of God to say, and when they came thither to the hill, behold, a company of prophets met him, and the prophet of God, Muhammad, came upon him, and he prophesied among them. You see, when you try to create a new definition for a word, like claiming spirit and prophet are the same, you create problems. Do you need more examples, O Mohammedan? Let me ask, how many more examples do you need, O Mohammedan? 2 Chronicles 15:1, and the Spirit of God came upon Azariah, the son of Oded. Applying Deedat's error corrupts the word of God to say, and the prophet of God, Muhammad, came upon Azariah, the son of Oded. This next one I really love. All the while my breath is in me, and the Spirit of God is in my nostrils. Applying Deedat's error corrupts the word of God to say, all the while my breath is in me, and the prophet of God, Muhammad, is in my nostrils. Look at that again, O Mohammedan. Changing the word spirit into the word prophet corrupts the word of God to say, Muhammad is in his nose. O Mohammedan, can you see how foolish it is to claim the Holy Spirit of God is the Holy Prophet of God? The next one, however, is even more damning of Deedat's argument, his twisted, tortured teaching. Job 33:4, the Spirit of God hath made me, and the breath of the Almighty has given me life. The Prophet of God, Mohammed, hath made me. Look at that again, O Mohammedan. The Prophet of God, Mohammed, hath made me. Deedat's error leads you into this position that Mohammed is your creator. O Mohammedan, do you now begin to see how wrong Deedat's claim is? How many more examples do you need, O Mohammedan? I will show you one final example from the New Testament, from the Injil. Matthew 1:20. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit. If Deedat is correct, Mohammed impregnated Mary. I think that is enough to show you. Holy Spirit does not mean holy prophet. Spirit does not mean prophet. You cannot change the word spirit into the word prophet. So we are teaching you about error number 3 that Deedat commits, when Deedat is not consistent applying his claim that Muhammad is the Holy Spirit. If Deedat were consistent, he would have seen the foolishness of his claim. But again, we prove Deedat had no interest in the truth. If you call yourself Muslim, you need to ask yourself, do you place any value on truth? The truth is that spirit does not mean prophet. Do you want to be an adult who thinks with the mind Jehovah God gave you? Both logic and the truth shred the web of errors and lies Deedat spun like a spider to deceive you. O Mohammedan, do you place any value on the truth or on knowledge and understanding? The truth is that Holy Spirit does not mean holy prophet. Christians, do not be deceived by the lies and errors from Islam. Christians, pray for those who call themselves Muslim. Pray that all who have sincere hearts would hear the truth and their hearts would receive the truth and be set free from Satan's bondage. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.